Apparently, Douglas had designed the DC-3 for 21 passengers. By the mid-50s, when more powerful 1,250-horsepower engines had replaced the originals on most of the aircraft and bigger payloads were practical, the standard airline DC-3 configuration had 24 passenger seats and a galley. With no intention of serving anything to anybody, Fluke Airways didn't need galleys. We had seats for 28 passengers. We did have the modern convenience of racks for carry-on luggage. If you struggled up that little stairway with your suitcases instead of trusting them to the uncertainties of Fluke's baggage system, you could put them in a convenient luggage bay right across from the door next to the tiny restroom and the bottle of drinking water. The bay was about 5 feet long and 3 feet deep with shelves above and below. Now, looking back 40 years, I can't recall any straps across the front of those shelves to keep suitcases from bouncing out onto people in rough weather. There must have been straps, but nobody took them seriously. You could put smaller items like briefcases in the overhead rack above your seat. Again, in those far-off days, there were no doors up there. If things got bouncy, you might take a dangerous-looking object off the rack and put it back in the luggage bay, but it was no big deal. I don't remember anybody's being injured, either. The bottle of drinking water was a sore point with the pursers. About the same time they'd been relieved of gassing up the airplane, they were assigned to fill that bottle with a couple of gallons of water at the beginning of every flight and wrestle it into position upside down with its spigot at the bottom close to the paper cups. This was a real pain in the midst of taking tickets, hunting for missing passengers, and sorting the baggage in the cargo pit. On the other hand, the health benefits were significant. Until the job went to the pursers, it had been handled by the same crew that emptied the honey buckets from the restrooms, and those fellows were too busy to wash their hands often. It had taken only a few years for Fluke management to notice a potential problem in this. Fortunately, hardly anybody ever wanted a drink of water. The rear cargo pit was just a big closet at the back of the airplane. A door opened into it from the cabin, and a hatch on the side of the plane let the crews load and unload while standing on the ground there near the tail. The purser spent a surprising amount of time in the cargo pit, sorting bags and boxes to be unloaded at the next stop. You could grab a loop of webbing riveted to a bulkhead while you leaned over and worked with your other hand. Now that gives some reassurance because the cargo hatch was usually bent up a bit, and as you worked, you could see the ground through a crack in the hatch. You always half suspected the hatch would pop open at any moment and drop you out. The cabin door to the cargo pit was often left open for other reasons.
Steward, it's awfully hot in here. Can you turn up the air conditioning?
Yes, it is hot. This plane doesn't have air conditioning, but I can probably help a little bit. All I could do was to open the door to the cargo pit, where there was a large vent to the outside. Then open the door to the cockpit up front and ask the pilot to open the cockpit side windows. A very gentle flow of air would then move from the cargo pit forward through the cabin and out the windows. Ma'am, does that help a little?
I guess it does. Do you know what the temperature is?
Yeah, there's a thermometer right back here. Yes, it says 107 degrees. That's Fahrenheit, of course, not centigrade.
How high are we?
Oh, about 1,000 feet. That's where we usually are here between Summit City and Marston.
Wouldn't it be cooler if we went higher?
We'd have to go a lot higher to make any difference, and it would take longer.
We wouldn't want it to take longer.
Does the airplane always roll back and forth so much? Oh, not always, but the thermals coming up from the fields are very uneven, and they cause the swaying and lurching.
I don't think I can stand much more of this.
There's a whoops bag in the seat pocket in front of you. No, use the whoop.
Oh, I wish you hadn't done that.
Use the whoops bag. Please, sir, use the...
Oh.
Is the bag in this pocket?
Yes, it's...
Oh.